The University Hospital of Antwerp is an academic hospital and it offers tertiary medical care for the Antwerp region, which is about 1.5 million inhabitants. Our department of gastroenterology and hepatology is one of the key departments within internal medicine. The primary areas of research in our department of hepatology are non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, viral hepatitis, and the treatment of primary and secondary liver tumors. The hallmark of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is the accumulation of fat in the liver hepatocytes. It's very prevalent. We estimate that about 1/3 of the adult Western population has some degree of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. However, in only about 10% of these patients, there is also associated inflammation and a risk of progressive fibrosis and cirrhosis. The research we are conducting focuses on three items: the vascular modifications inside the liver and the changes in intrahepatic resistance and endothelial function. The role of several immune cells, not only in the liver, but also in visceral and subcutaneous adipose tissue. And a third line of research is on the role of autophagy and ER stress in physiopathology of NASH. We can translate results to the development of targeted drugs for this disease. And these drugs are currently already in clinical trials. We have developed a close collaboration with the Department of Diabetology and also with the Obesity Clinic and Bariatric Surgery. A lot more patients at risk are diagnosed. We also closely collaborate with other physicians in other specialties. So this offers a more comprehensive approach for the treatment of these patients.
The prevalence of viral hepatitis in Antwerp is much higher compared to the general Belgian population. And that's due to the fact that more than 150 different nationalities live in Antwerp. Most of them are first or second generation immigrants coming from high endemic countries. A lot of patients currently present with end-stage liver disease due to chronic hepatitis B or C virus infections, and often they already have hepatocellular carcinoma. Hepatitis B and C are known to be a silent killer. They do not induce symptoms for several years, up to decades. The current antiviral regimens we have at hand are able to completely stop disease progression and in fact lead to a dramatic drop in mortality rate. A screening for viral hepatitis has been shown to be cost effective. We are currently performing community outreaches to screen for viral hepatitis in ethnic minorities. We are able to do so because we've invested a lot in personal contacts with key opinion leaders from the Chinese community in Antwerp. As such, we have been invited to give talks about the problem of viral hepatitis in the Asian community. We are actively involved in several international clinical trials which test the safety and the antiviral efficacy of new antiviral compounds for both hepatitis B virus infections and hepatitis C virus infections. We truly believe that we will be able to cure every HCV-infected patient without any harmful side effects in the near future.
It's a place where a patient with a liver tumor, newly diagnosed, can be seen by different specialists: an oncologist, an hepatologist, a surgeon, a hepatobiliary surgeon, a radiologist, at one time and in one location. The multidisciplinary approach is important because those tumors are quite complex tumors and often need a lot of different examinations and a lot of different treatments or a combination of treatments done by different specialists.
Our research program is interested in prevention of postoperative liver failure. If you resect disease of the liver, operative liver failure could occur. Once it occurs after resection, it goes along with a high morbidity and mortality. So we were interested in the measurement of liver function after resection. We adapted an old technique, the meprophilin clearance capacity of the liver, and with this technique we could measure minimum liver function after resection. If the patient has a function below that cutoff, we present him an alternative approach. So he goes first in portal vein embolization, and then we can resect in a safe method. And so we could now prevent liver failure after resection from 12% to 1%.
The future for our department is first to continue to work on our main research lines. We will continue to intensify our collaboration with our referring centers in order to optimize clinical care of our patients. And finally, it's very important, especially for research, but also for clinical care, to collaborate with other institutions. We have a lot of collaborations with Belgian universities, but also we are part of bigger consortia, European worldwide consortia. This is the way to make the field move forward.